Beware, all you maker of things. I have got a full color 3D scanner and a full color 3D printer. I am capable of making exact copies of... Oh. Hey everybody. As much of a history as I have with 3D printing, I have a long history of 3D scanning, and it's not a good one. My first experience was backing a Kickstarter for a $400 3D scanner, which I thought was completely reasonable, and it is a absolutely beautiful package, this scanner. It looks complete and ready to go. However, its software toolchain, while capable of running the machine and taking a full scan, could never quite figure out the calibration. It could never find its own center point, and so things were either too big or too small on top of itself. And what's worse is it couldn't ever line up its own lasers with the center point. And so if you tried to do a scan with both lasers, they wouldn't overlap. It just was not a good experience. Then I got the Cyclop 3D scanner, an open source 3D scanner, which means it's better, right? Sure, it looks like it's a pile of, well, it's thrown together a little bit, but it's open source. Unfortunately, being open source, it kind of fell to a bad trap of open source projects where it gets to a point where they say, well, this is the hardware, it's hardware complete, everything from here out is software, and we're sure somebody will figure it out. And no one ever does. And while the Cyclop scanner is theoretically good, and I suppose one day somebody might make the software to scan it, I don't think anybody has managed to get a good scan off of a Cyclop scanner. I've seen lots of people who have tried, but I haven't seen any results from this machine that I'm actually impressed with. Not to mention the plug is for European adapters, and it comes with a plug. I mean, look at that thing, that's ridiculous. At the Makerspace, we had a Aisne scan, which is more than $1,000 3D scanner. And you would think that for $1,000, it would be a good experience. However, it was months of me interacting with their customer service, trying to figure out what was wrong, until I finally found out that the scanner that we had, the hardware that we had, wasn't in their database for some reason. They had a draconian DRM on there that called home every time I wanted to scan something and said, nope, it looks like you've got a pirate version of our hardware. Do people actually pirate the Aisne scan? Has that been a problem, or did they put this in there hoping that somebody would, so that they would catch it, and the only thing that they actually caught were the honest users trying to use their software who had the one that wasn't in their database? It just blows my mind. Now, in the end, the Aisne scanner has been a good experience now that I've got it up and running. Then I meet the Scan Dimensions folks at the Bay Area Maker Faire, and they've got the Soul scanner. And we immediately hit it off, build a rapport. Great people, and I really enjoyed meeting with them. And so I said to them, hey, any chance you'd be willing to give one of your scanners to a moderately successful YouTube channel? And they said, well, we'll loan it to you. So I got to play with this scanner. Now, it's half the price of an Aisne scanner, and by their own admission, it doesn't make scans that are as detailed as the Aisne scan. However, having the experiences that I had with 3D scanning, I was willing to give it a try. And you know what? This machine has been the best experience with 3D scanning that I have yet had. The hardware setup was super easy. The software setup was flawless. Taking that first scan was no problem whatsoever, and it produced an output I didn't even have to think about it. Honestly, this was a great experience, and a couple of things that I love about it. First of all, they put their calibration right on their turntable here, so this machine doesn't need to have any sort of fancy stand that you have to keep onto the side here. It's got its calibration right here with it. Now, to have a good 3D scan, you really need to have a dark environment. And at the Makerspace, when I use the Aisne scanner, half the time I turn off the lights to do it. But these guys give you a really neat little package that has this inside of it. How cool is that? It's a little dark room that just fits right over the top of the scanner and makes it so that it can take perfect scans without you having to be in a dark room. I think it's absolutely gorgeous. It has like dark felt on the inside, so there's no reflection. And then it just collapses down, folds in, and gets put away just like that. This is super cool and super fun, and just one of the little things that makes this scanner so cool. Now, the first thing I wanted to do, of course, was to 3D scan an object and then 3D print it on the DaVinci Color, and so I tried out a rubber ducky. Now, they actually put a rubber ducky in the package, but with six kids, it disappeared rather quickly. I'm not sure where it was, but fortunately, I've got a spare rubber ducky. And it was a neat experience. You put it on there, you scan it, you tilt it over and let it scan again. And the scans are accurate enough, even at different angles, that they mesh together to make a complete mesh. Now, looking at the scan, it's pretty clear that reflections and shadows were still being captured in this process. It wasn't a perfectly smooth scan. This should have been all yellow, but it had some of the shadows in it. That coupled with the DaVinci Color's tendency to overdo it on the dark and black colors meant that the final print came out weird and kind of shadowy all over the place, although it did catch some of the hot underneath it. And for some reason, my cyan stopped printing before it got to the eyes. My son provided a solution for that, though. There we go. Still, this scan seemed to be, to me, approximately dimensionally accurate. It certainly didn't catch all of the little creases inside the wings here. It kind of smoothed over them, but it's as big as the original duck, and it seems, by all measurements that I could take just looking at it, to be pretty darn accurate. So I decided to do a round trip. Take a 3D model, 3D print it out, like a chibi mall here. I 3D printed this in wood fill on the longer Cube 2 3D printer because it would make a nice matte finish and would be an easy model to scan. Then take this 3D model, scan it in, and compare it to the original model. So let's jump in and do that right now. So here we are in Blender, and we've got the original model and we've got the scan. And looking at this scan, hoo boy, I would not feel bad if you looked at that scan and said, that is absolutely terrible. But let's put that aside for just a second. Let's move it over and see how it lines up with the original. So I'm going to just turn on wireframe so we can kind of see through it, but take a look. The scan is smaller than the original model in every single dimension. What, like, they're missing it. They're missing it by quite a lot. The scan is coming out at being from shoulder to shoulder about 44 millimeters, where the original one from shoulder to shoulder is about 45.5 millimeters across. That's a huge miss. And I mean, with it being this inaccurate though, how could it possibly stitch things together? The only explanation would be, hold on a second. Ah, the longer cube prints things a little bit too small. I should use a better calibrated 3D printer for this. Okay, point to the sole scanner. It actually measured it accurate to the print, not to the model. So let's adjust the model down just a little bit to make it be approximately the same size and see how we can compare apples to apples here. So shrinking this down until it's about the same size shoulder to shoulder. That is about right. So now that they're lined up a little bit better, we can still see that the scan is, it kind of smooths over everything. It doesn't quite get as pointy as the pointiness. It doesn't quite get as creasy as the creasiness. The general shape is there, and if you were using this just for the purpose of measuring, if you were using this as a reference to model off of, it's an accurate measure, but it didn't quite capture the shape. I contacted the people at Scan Dimensions and said, hey guys, this is my result so far. And they said, wow, that really isn't very good. We've gotten much better scans from it. Did you do more than one passes, and did you do it in close mode? And I said, well, I only did one pass because I printed this one without a bottom and I didn't want that to, what do you mean close mode? And they said, oh, you can take the head and move it closer for small objects. Brilliant. So popping back into Blender here, here is the scan that I made in close mode. And you can see that it is much better than the one that was taken in far mode. And in fact, if we look at it in wireframe mode here, you'll see that this scan is actually a much denser mesh than the one that was taken in far mode. It has more points there to scan, which I think is remarkable. But how does it compare to the original? Let's move it over and find out. So once again, it's a little bit smoother, not quite as creasy, but not nearly as bad as the first one. In fact, it's considerably more accurate. And overall, for a $600 3D scanner that can nail it this close, that's pretty darn good. And I know that if I were to do multiple passes, do an object that I can turn on its side and let it get data from multiple directions, that the scan will just get better and better the more passes and angles that I let it get at it. So for a $600 3D scanner, this is a really, really good result. Now, I should mention what I want a 3D scanner for in the first place. I don't want to just scan silly things and print out things that are approximately the same shape as them. This, for me, is a measuring tool. Now, I'm not under any illusions that I'm going to be able to take an object, scan it in, and then directly print it. But I do want to take an object that's at odd angles and has dimensions that, while I could measure it, it would be a lot easier if I could have a reference to measure it in Blender as I'm working, or Fusion 360. This part is the part for a tent. It's a very functional part, but it needs to be this specific shape, this specific size, these specific holes. And so I thought, okay, I'm gonna scan this in. Now you might notice that it's got this white powder all over it. That is, foot powder. Very stinky stuff, but it takes a black model and turns it into one that scans a lot easier, and then it washes off afterwards. I also put a little bit of blue tack on here, and again, I did the single pass on this and then just scanned it in. And I'm going to go ahead and do the modeling of this off camera and probably tell you in another video how it works, but I'm excited to have the Soul Scanner so that I could do that. And as useful of a tool as this is for doing 3D scanning, and honestly, it doesn't take up much space on your desk, just put it in the corner and put its little lid on it and it'll be fine. This, if you're doing 3D scanning, if you find yourself pulling out your calipers a lot to measure things, having a scanner like this might be just the boon that you need to take your modeling to the next level. Well, there you go, the Soul Scanner by Scan Dimensions. I'll put a link in the description where you can check them out and see what you think about them. They're great people. I think that they've made a great scanner, and honestly, this has been the best experience that I've had with 3D scanning to date. For that alone, I could recommend these guys. Before we go, check out this cool project on the What You Makin' channel on my Discord. Why don't you stop by and check out what other cool projects are there? And hey, if you share something you've done, maybe you'll see it in a future video too. Thank you very much for watching. Hey, if I mentioned anything in this video, you'll find a link to it in the cards and you should check that out. Did you know that I'm social? I've got links to all the socials and you should stop by and say hi. I really kind of enjoy it when that happens. Big thanks go out to my direct backers, and if you want to know more about how you can become that, there'll be a link right here that you can check out. And as always, I want to remind you, safety first, because I care about you.
and I'll see you next time. Oh, that's interesting. Classic one there.